box fort shout.
Oh no, Logan.
Hey you, stop right there. Oh no, he's got a weapon. Mind if we can make it? Ah! What's happening? I think the Titanic is going down.
We are gonna be doing box fort city. That's right, we are gonna be converting this entire backyard into our very own box fort city. We're gonna have our own houses, a hospital, a police station, an arcade, a grocery store, everything that you have in the city.
Logan, did I leave anything out?
Oh no!
Did I leave anything out of the city?
You forgot our restaurant and a movie theater.
True. They also have street lights and roads and cars. We're gonna have all of it. So this is kind of like a rundown house in the neighborhood. I'm not sure exactly what we're gonna do with this place yet. We're thinking maybe we'll make it the general store or something of the sorts.
The starting point of the city.
Yeah, exactly. It's like the mayor's house, you know, something like that, something we build up. The way the box fort city is gonna work, not only are me and Logan gonna have our own houses, but we're also gonna have to have our own jobs to get money to buy things for our houses.
I'm gonna be a brick builder.
Logan's gonna be, okay, don't, you know, I don't think you should be a brick builder. You're not good at that. If we wanna add on to our houses, you know, buy air conditioning, buy a TV, buy a gaming system, these are all things that we're gonna have to earn in box fort city by doing jobs. So the more that we put into them, the better we build them, and the more stuff we buy from the general store, the more fun we're gonna have. I mean, Logan might, for example, forget to buy a bed, and I buy a bed, and I have a place to sleep where he's sleeping on the ground.
But Logan, you gotta get off the unicorn, man, because we got some building to do, bro.
We have a massive shipment coming from Amazon with a ton of really cool stuff that we can add to our fort, as well as stuff that we can add to the general store. It's not here yet, but I thought in the meantime, we could start by actually working on the city. I mean, we need to make a road, we need to make both me and Logan's houses to start, and a general store to buy our stuff. So we got a lot of work to do.
The sun is currently, it's up there.
I promise you it's up there, but it will be coming down soon. So we might have to make sure our houses are ready for tonight because we're sleeping here tonight, guys.
I think I'm gonna sleep here today.
I'll let you sleep in the water and get attacked by the raccoons, but I got my nice mansion, which I'm gonna be building over here. So I think it's time to grab some cardboard, grab some tape, and start building our very own box fort city houses.
All right, guys, so for my house, I'm gonna be starting it a little bit small. I'm gonna have a 4x4 with my cardboard here.
As always, if we want, we can expand on. The way that this is gonna work is that cardboard and tape is completely free. It's the stuff that we put in our houses that we're gonna have to buy with money from our job. One thing I definitely am gonna wanna add on when I can afford it is buying a car and making a garage.
Drive it around here, you know, maybe go over there to the beach, swim in the ocean, and of course go over and visit Logan's house.
It's gonna be better than your house, Logan. It's gonna be way better than your house. Your house is gonna stick.
This is where I am going to set up my home. So I am going to build my awesome home right over here. You'll come on this nice little welcome path where my box fort home will be. So, let's start building.
So we just got one of the first shipments in with a ton of the stuff that we're gonna be using for Box Fort City Week. And I'm not gonna show off everything right now because that would be like ridiculously hard. But let's just say we got everything from door locks for our box forts over to robot companions that we can buy for our house that will help us clean up. So there's a lot of stuff in here, you know, most of which we're gonna have to buy from the general store, but I'm really excited. So I gotta get back outside and keep building.
One of the things I know 100% that I'm gonna be making for this box fort is a working shower. I actually bought a working pump that's gonna pump the water. So one of these areas I'm gonna need to waterproof so that we can actually have the water, you know, flow down and then out the shower.
As nice as this area is, all these rocks are really sharp and they're coming through the cardboard. They wouldn't make a very comfortable bed. So in that case, we are going to move our box fort next to the general store.
So far my house is looking pretty sweet. You have a nice view of the ocean.
And we're right next to the general store. So if we need anything, we just come out, say, hey, what's up? And we grab whatever we need.
Okay guys, so check this out. We've got the main part of the fort built. As you can see, I've got my interior here with the four squares. We got the wall set up. I've even got a little welcome mat down here for my front door. All I need to do now before I can actually start working on the interior is setting up the roof. But because this is Box Fort City, you know, I didn't really want to just do a normal flat roof. I thought it'd be really cool to have a little bit of curb appeal. So I think what I'm going to try and do is maybe do like a slanted roof. And then even if it rains, the water should just kind of pour off the side. So I don't have to worry about my house caving in during the night. Because if we do stay here for a couple of days, I definitely don't want it caving in. Now it's my task to start working on getting the general store up and running. And as you guys can see,
This place is completely destroyed. I mean, this is what happens when you leave a box fort in a few thunderstorms and in the sun for like 5 or 6 days. As of right now, I mean, there's a lot of room in here and a lot of gross cardboard, so I think I need to clear this out. We can obviously expand the general store, but I think for now I'm gonna keep it fairly simple and small so we can at least start getting our first building items. So check it out, my fort is almost completely finished. We've got the exterior here looking real nice and awesome. I wasn't able to actually do the roof part because it was a little bit too hard and would waste a lot of cardboard, but I still think it came out looking really cool. At the front here, we've got our front door, which looks pretty sweet, and we even have a little welcome mat down here, so when you walk in, you can wipe your feet off so you don't track anything on inside. Now, before this thing can be officially complete and we can start this challenge, we did both get a starter pack full of different things that we can equip our house with. So, I mean, I got like lights in here, mostly all the cool items like air conditioning stoves, gaming consoles, you know, all of that stuff, and snacks. We have to buy with money that we earn in the box fort city, but this is a really good starter pack to get us started, and I think I'm about time to deck out my fort. But before I do that, wanna bring you guys inside
and show you what it looks like. So right now it's a little small, but you know, there's always room for expansion. This is the main area here, so we've got like a little table over there.
I think if I can afford it eventually, I'd love to get like a flat screen TV here, maybe set up a Nintendo Switch or an Xbox so I can play Fortnite. Behind me I think is where I'm gonna put the kitchen. Right now we're probably just gonna have to live off of snacks, but if I can eventually get food, I can actually cook it inside here in the kitchen. Over here there's this wall, but actually if you grab here where the little handle is and slide it to the side, this is my bedroom. So it's a nice little compartment for my bedroom. I'm gonna put my mattress in here. I've got a nice window. And when you're done, you can slide it over here just like that. This is gonna be one of the coolest features. I'm gonna have a shower. So I'm actually gonna be using one of the items in my starter kit to build myself a working shower. One of the most usable showers we've ever had in a box fort. So I'm really excited about that. We got LED panels that I guess we can put on the wall. They're actually, oh, that's so cool. They're like real light switches. Some LED strips, so definitely good for lighting. This is what I was talking about. This is gonna be my shower. Still gotta read the instructions, don't really know how to set this thing up, but it will be a battery powered shower that'll actually pump real water into my shower, so pretty pumped about that. Front door lock with a key so we can lock our box fort at night, very important so no intruders, Logan, or raccoons get in. Oh, we got some snacks in here to start us off. We got moon cheese.
Guys, check it out, our box fort house is complete and it is looking so awesome. I love this door and I'm loving the look of this mansion, my home for the next however long. But before we get a job and we make some money, we do have a starter kit to deck out our fort. It is looking amazing, but guys, it is like 100 degrees in there, which is why it is so key I built my house right outside of the pool. So in times like these when it's super hot, we can just go outside and jump in the pool. Woo!
Camping mattress slash bed all set up in my bedroom, completely air filled. Got a beautiful view of the pool slash the ocean. And of course we can shut the door like this. We want a little bit of privacy. And then lie back down in my nice comfy bed. It's actually really good, but oh, that's nice. Comes with a nice little pillow. I don't even think I'll need blankets because of how hot it's been lately, but we can obviously always bring in blankets. One of the first things I definitely want to buy from the general store is an air conditioner because it is boiling hot in here and I would love to get an air conditioner to cool this place down.
By the look of it, Jake's almost done his fort.
And I'm nowhere near done my fort.
So I just added a window to my fort. Let's head inside
and start decking it out.
So right now our fort is completely barren. There is pretty much nothing in here, but with this starter kit, I'm sure there are a lot of items. Like, I don't know what this is. Let's see. Oh, was not expecting a mirror. Check it out, guys. Woo! So, you know, you can wake up in the morning, check yourself out, make sure you're looking fresh. Probably hang that somewhere on the wall, but okay guys, check it out. We have a ton of stuff. We have a pillow. We have a doorknob. Okay, so I guess I'll put that on my door. We have some light bulbs, a cooling towel, I guess when it gets really hot out. Nice. Oh, a solar shower. Okay, we'll be setting this up for tomorrow. And we got some LED lights to put around our fort.
Coming together pretty nicely. All we need to get is a bed.
Okay guys, so check this out. I've just done a ton of work on the fort, upgrading it with some of the items that we got in our starter kit. And I have to say, this might be one of the craziest and best forts we've ever built. And I haven't even expanded it yet. I mean, I haven't bought anything from the general store and it's already looking amazing. Behind the scenes, this is actually where the shower is gonna go. For the first time ever, a working shower with an actual working electric pump. So the shower head is up here and it's connected all the way down here to this bucket of water, which has been sitting out in the sun, so it's nice and warm. Cause you know, I like my showers warm at the end of the night. I mean, just cause we're in a box fort doesn't mean we can't have a nice warm shower. And then there's an electric switch, which I've mounted on the inside of the box fort. So you press this, it activates the pump inside the water here. And then we've got a working shower. Now come to the front here, because you'll notice I added our very first working box fort lock. So this is actually locked right now. I can't turn it, and on the inside, I'll show you how it works. So you need the key, simply turn it to unlock. Now it actually turns and we can open. And the way it works on the backside here is when the door handle's locked, this actually stays down so you can't pull the door off. Now the fort's a little messy right now, but I did install the lights. Here, I haven't put my LED lights in yet, but we got some lights here and another light over here. So still need to add the LEDs, and I do know that they sell more lights at the general store, so I definitely want to grab some more lights. But like I said, I think the first thing's gonna be that air conditioner, because it's really hot in here. Coming over here to the shower, let's slide this door back over and release the shower door. If you come in, you can see the shower head is up there, and I actually installed a little shower light here, so let's turn that on. Just by pressing that, there you go. You got a nice little light in the shower, lights up the whole place. Now, I don't really feel like taking a shower right now, so I'm not actually gonna sit under it, but to show you guys how it works, so you press this button, and there we go. We have a world's first working box fort shower. Now, I made it here so the water can't get out of here, and I actually installed a little drain here so it can all just kind of fall out there. But yeah, we've got a working shower in a box fort at the press of a button. How sweet is that? And of course, when we're done, don't forget to close the front door, lock up so no one can get in.
The sun is going down and our fort is looking pretty awesome. We have some lights up here. We have LED strips all around the side of the fort. And over here, we have our electronic charging station. We have our toiletries, so we have a mirror and a face cloth. I still need to get my toothbrush and some other stuff. And then this side of the fort is pretty much storage. Probably gonna have an outdoor shower. And right here we have a tarp. I think tomorrow I'm gonna make a nice tarped shade area so I can cool off whenever it's too hot. And now it's time to plug in our power source. We have power, woohoo! Guys, that is looking awesome. We officially have our lights on, and we got these lights, which are pretty sweet. The whole point of this week is to get a job, make some money, and buy stuff to expand our forts. But so far, I am really loving my fort. Just check out my comfy pillow. It's time to set up our shower. I think we just put it in the water and fill it up. We have ourselves a shower. Okay, it's time to hang it on a tree. So we sit down on our rock and we wake up with a nice morning shower.
It's time to go over and check out Logan's fort and see what's going on. Oh, it looks like he's got his door handle on here. I guess I'll just... Logan, you home? Let me see. Oh, what's up, dude? It's looking pretty cool. A little smaller than my fort, but you know. You know,
pretty much we have the essentials over here, Jake. We have the phone charger.
Okay, all right, I don't have that in mind.
We have the mirror and my nice comfortable bed.
That is comfortable.
And when I wanna go to bed, Jake, just gotta close the window like this and we have darkness.
I mean, like I said, guys, we didn't get all of the cool stuff in our starter pack. Most of the cool things we do need to buy. So interested to see what Logan buys. I do like your light bulbs up here.
No, this is a nice start. I'm happy with the start of my fort. And as you guys know, the point of this is to make it more and more luxurious. Jake, what did you just do to my lights?
Buttons on the light. Oh, that's cool. That's cool. I like that. That was like a fiery fort. I thought, because this is a little bit small, why don't you come back to my fort, check it out. We can have dinner in my fort before we go to bed tonight. Plus, I want to show you some of the cool stuff I have.
The La Papa Jake Mansion, as I call it. Of course, got my keys here, so I gotta open it up. Security is one of my number one priorities. And there we go. Welcome to the fort, Logan.
It's all pretty nice here. We got our LED lights working. We also got lights on the wall here, so behind if you want to turn those on. Make sure it's nice and bright in the middle of the night, because you know me, I don't like raccoons or anything scary coming in the middle of the night, so that's why we got the bright lights.
Over here, Logan, is where I've got my sleeping quarters, but one of the coolest things is a special little door here, Logan. I haven't told you about this, but if you go in here, Logan, something magical happens.
What are these holes, Jake?
Don't worry about those. So now all you gotta do, Logan, is press that button on the wall there.
It's some kind of prank,
no,
Jake.
No, it's not a prank, Logan.
This seems like a very weird room, Jake.
No, it's perfectly normal room. Just press the button on the wall. You're gonna see how normal and cool.
We're normal and cool.
Jake,
it's my in-house shower.
No.
Hey, we got the drainage system working.
Oh, Jake.
But yeah, that's my shower.
Cardboard in water is a... It's not a good idea,
that's why I got the drainage system.
It's why I have an outdoor shower, Jake.
Okay, all right. Well, for dinner, I thought we could, because this is a house, a legitimate house, I thought we would order ourselves some pizza just like you would with a normal house. And before the pizza gets here, Logan, I gotta serve my guests some moon cheese.
I insist.
Jake, I don't think I really want
what
moon
the
cheese.
Eat, Logan.
This does not look good.
Logan, I'm just trying to be nice to my guests here. This is literally from the moon.
I don't like that.
It's like if you took cheese and made it crunchy. Oh, dude, check it out. We got our very first meal inside our box fort city.
This is a big pizza.
Oh,
that is good pizza.
Well, we finished up our food. We are completely done our pizza. It was actually really nice. We had it delivered to our house. As you guys can see, the sun has gone down. It's currently nighttime. So I think for today, we're gonna probably head to bed. We got a lot of stuff to do tomorrow. We have to visit the general store. We have to get our jobs. We have to also upgrade the box for its city and start adding on. Like, I wanna do roads and stuff. So there's a ton of things to do. So I think it's time for me to open up my bedroom here and head on in and get to bed. And Logan, I think it's time for you to go back to your house.
Yeah, Jake, I'll see you in the morning.
Time for me to lock my door so no raccoons get in tonight.
I even got a little bed light, Logan, check it out. So I can have it really bright, or these are dimmable so I can dim it.
Okay, Jake, I will see you in the morning. Guys, let's head over to my fort.
Coming back to my house, we'll lock the door tonight. And let's make the lights white.
All right, there we go.
Like Jake said, we have a lot of stuff to do tomorrow. Okay, got my phone charged. We'll turn off the lights. And I'll see you guys in the morning.
Let's open up here and check out the rest of the box fort. Of course, because it is morning time, before we have our breakfast, I thought it would be really smart to use our shower. Of course, no proper luxury box fort would be complete without my morning shower. All right. Woohoo! Oh, that is nice. Ah. All right, well, I'm gonna take a little quick shower, just get my hair wet, wake up a little bit. And I'll update you guys in a second.
That was a pretty good sleep.
Let's turn on our LEDs. And I think it's time to order some breakfast. So let's go on Uber Eats and get some bagels. While we wait for our breakfast, I think it is time to start the day with a nice, relaxing shower. Oh, that's cold. No, I don't like that. Oh, guys, that is so cold.
I ran into your Uber food, man. Why don't we go inside your house and eat breakfast?
Check it out, we got some nice breakfast bagels.
Now that we're done our breakfast, it's time to head on over to the general store where we can check out what is being sold. And of course, guys, because this is Box Fort City, if we want to buy any upgrades to our own houses, we need to buy it here in the general store. So why don't we go inside and see what they got.
Hello? Anyone home?
Welcome you two to my Box Fort store in Box Fort City. Land of the free, how can I help?
We just came by to check out the store, see what you got for sale.
Well, you're not gonna find any better items around here. That's because I'm the only store that sells them. But I've got all the things you could want for your box fort house, for a price, of course. We've got air conditioners, robot dogs, robot helpers,
whoa,
toy cars.
That's cool, you do have a lot of stuff.
I want the AC, Jake.
Oh, I also want an LED expansion for more lights in my house.
Sir, how much does all this stuff cost?
Well, everything's got a price in my store, so if you bring it up here, I'll run you up at the cash register. Nothing's cheap here. I make my money just like you. You get yourself a job in Box Fort City and come back when you got the dough.
I guess we have to get jobs then.
All right, well, I mean, the only thing we can do, guys, is go to the job board and check out what jobs are available in Box Fort City.
All right, well, come again when you got some money. I'll be here. Rusty Dave.
We currently have a general store over there. Logan's house, which is all the way over there. It's really small. You probably can't even see it.
No, my house is lit.
You're gonna have to expand it.
And of course, we got my house up in front here, working shower in the back.
and even a bedroom. But today we have a ton of stuff to do, and I thought today we could get our very first job so we could go back to that general store, slap down a stack of cash, and say, I want to buy everything. This is, of course, Boxford City, so we also need to expand the city. So I'm thinking today we also work on the very first road that will connect Logan's house to my house, because eventually, guys, we want to buy cars to drive in the city. And like any road, we're going to need to build streetlights, and our jobs are probably going to need places.
Jake, I think the first thing we need to do today is get our jobs.
Okay, all right, why don't we go over to the job hut, figure out what our jobs are, and then we can start working on the road. That's not where you find your job. Your job's not in the water. It's at the job hut.
Welcome to the job hut. Basically, any jobs that are available in Boxford City are posted in here. We can take a look at them and grab whichever one we want. So why don't I go in and see what my first job's gonna be?
Really hope I get something cool, like race car driver. Maybe I could be the mayor of Box City.
They're hiring police officers and it pays $100 a day. I could be the sheriff of Boxford City.
Oh no, I don't know about Sheriff Papa Jake. No, 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 no.
This job, $100 a day, I get to be a police officer stopping crime.
Okay, let's check out what kind of jobs. Ooh, random job. Okay, I'll pick random job.
Let's see what you can get for random job.
Archaeologist? Jake, I don't want to be an archaeologist.
Well, I mean, maybe it pays a lot of money. What does it pay?
It has a question mark next to pay.
Well okay, that makes sense, because if you're an archaeologist, you only get paid if you find something. That's fine. All you gotta do is dig in the ground. Keep on digging until you see like some bones. You take the bones in.
I don't want to be an archaeologist.
Well, you picked random, man. I mean, the job board's closed for the day, so better luck next time. But I'm gonna go get my cop stuff and suit up for the day. I want to make this $100.
Good luck digging up dirt. No, don't.
Okay, guys, so I'm back inside my house, and it looks like my cop gear has arrived. So, of course, I get a nice little blaster to take down the bad guys, and some real deal handcuffs to cuff anyone. I mean, hopefully we don't have to use these, but at the end of the day, we are getting $100. Of course, though, before I head out, as a cop, I gotta make sure I'm looking fresh, so why don't I go over here to the shower? There's no point in having a Boxford shower if you don't freshen up. Whew! Okay, that's cool. I'm actually pretty excited for this. Get to be Officer Papa Jake. I need to buy some towels though. I do not have any towels in this fort. That is definitely on my list of things to buy.
Okay, well before I do any archaeology or anything of that sort, there are some upgrades I want to make to my house. So before we do anything, let's make a second story for my house.
I was thinking though, guys, before we head out and actually do our jobs, and before Logan heads to the mines or wherever he's gonna go look for archaeologists, I don't even know what archaeologists really do, before he goes and does that, I thought it'd be a great time to do some additions to the actual city itself. I had the really cool idea of connecting me and Logan's fort via a road, so if in the future we buy cars, we can actually drive to each other's houses, and I wanna add streetlights so at night, our Boxford city's lit up like a real city.
Well, let's put my cop stuff on my little table here.
Which soon enough will be housing my brand new flat screen TV, which I'm gonna buy for my base. And let's head out and start building some additions to our Boxford City.
You're not gonna help me build the streetlights. You're gonna really work on expanding your house.
Well, yeah, Jake, I have some things I want to build to my house. And
I'm putting in the effort here, man. I'm building the city. I'm like the mayor.
We don't really need streetlights, Jake. We don't even have cars.
If when we get cars, we're going to need streetlights. And if everyone gets us 50,000 likes, eventually we're going to buy cars. I want to buy like a little mini Lambo that I can drive around in.
Logan's house, Jake's house. The general store at the job hut.
Ooh, we might need a police station for my police job. I mean, if I catch a criminal, we got to put him somewhere.
That is true. Maybe I need my own office.
Yeah, I guess you could have your own office. All right, well, let's grab our cardboard, guys, and start working on the streetlights while Logan works on his addition and make this Boxford City awesome. I just finished installing all of our streetlights, and look at how cool this is. We've got the streetlights set up with the street in Boxford City. So we got the lines here, which represent the street of Boxford City. Because, you know, eventually when we do get cars and have to build our garages, we want to have a proper street to drive down. And then we've got all of our streetlights set up here. But the cool thing is they actually work. So underneath here, there's a lighting system. So at night, I mean, it's a little dark right now, but at night you'll be able to see them and it'll light up the whole road.
Oh, this is actually really cool.
Logan, I was thinking, why don't we grab some dinner because we are surviving out here. So enjoy a nice meal and then we'll head out and do our jobs for the day.
Before we get dinner, check this out. I have added my second story. Right now, I think this is a pretty good start to my office. I'm not done yet, but I am really hungry. So let's go eat. For dinner tonight, we have some sushi.
Obviously, we still have our jobs to do, but one of the biggest things is if I'm gonna be doing my job, Logan has his laboratory, but I don't have a police station yet, so I need to build myself a police station, which is gonna be an awesome addition to this Box Fort City, and then I'll have a place to put bad guys I catch.
Sun is going down, and we have just finished the second story of my box fort. You have a nice outdoor view of what's going on, but as well, we have some nice shade in my new office. We have a window if we want some extra light. We have my laptop. Because first things first, guys, I gotta do some research on what this archaeology job is. Okay, guys, so right here it says archaeology is the study of human
boring
recovery and analysis of
boring.
Hey guys, I don't know what this means, but I think what an archaeologist does is something like dig up rocks and stuff.
How's your jail coming along?
Pretty good. I mean, it's not just a jail, it's also the police station. We need a place to put the bad guys and to have a base of operations.
All right, well, I'm just gonna go and be an archaeologist.
All right, have fun with that, whatever that is.
I guess to start as an archaeologist, I need to get changed into some archaeology clothing and grab my archaeology gear. Okay guys, I am ready to be an archaeologist. The first step is finding a nice dig site. And right here, as you can see, there's a lot of dirt. That means we could find some good rocks.
Oh, guys, I think we got something.
Look at this. Now I'm no archaeologist, but from what I learned on Wikipedia, I should dig right here. This must be some sort of rare stone. Three stones. This one's really shiny, guys. It looks like metallic or something. For my first day as an archaeologist?
Guys, I think these stones could be pretty valuable.
Guys, I don't know about you, but... Oh, I just lost a stone.
I think this might be crystal, and it
could be worth a lot of money. Let's take them back to my office,
do a little research,
and tomorrow we'll bring them to the job hut.
All right, guys, let's take it back into our office. Ugh.
For safekeeping, we will keep them up here. So I think today was a pretty successful day in terms of our archaeology, and you know, we built our office. And let's go check on what Jake's doing.
So check it out, the Box Fort City at night is looking so sweet. We got all of the street lights turned on. You can see that the light's shining down, which leads both to Logan's house as well as my house. Now, I'm not sure exactly what Logan's up to, but I do know I have to start my job for the day. Of course, it's getting a little bit late, but that's because I have two shifts. I have one night shift and one early morning shift. As the brand new sheriff, AKA Officer Papa Jake, I gotta gear up and do my rounds and make sure that our Box Fort City stays safe at night.
All right, time to get inside. I actually haven't been home all day, so it's kind of nice to come back here.
I got my blaster in case things get out of hand. Hopefully I won't need to use this. And even more important, I got my handcuffs.
All right, I'm all geared up and ready to head out. It's just about nighttime now at Box Fort City, so expecting to have too much trouble around here. We don't really get a lot of issues.
Of course, as Officer Papa Jake, I like to make sure that things are beyond safe around here. So we're looking out for anyone doing anything wrong, you know, trying to rob into houses or anything like that. I'm also gonna wanna make sure that all the houses are locked up for the night, you know, just mostly security stuff. All right, first place, I'm already noticing we have an issue here.
If you look here, the general store, looks like they left the door open.
Gonna wanna make sure that nothing's going on in here.
This is Officer Papa Jake. Is anyone in here? Hello? Pete, this is Officer Papa Jake.
All right, general store looks clear. Doesn't look like anyone was tampering with it. I think they just forgot to close it for the day, so I'm gonna help them out. Give it a nice little close here. You know, it's the nice kind of stuff I like to do as an officer around here. Being a sheriff slash officer is a really important responsibility, so. You know, a lot of people ask Papa Jake, is it hard to be Officer Papa Jake? Logan's a geologist or archaeologist, whatever he is, and you know, being so much cooler and more awesome, having a better job than him. Someone's gotta make sure the Box Fort City stays safe at night, and that's me. Speaking of which, I think we should head on over to Logan's house, make sure nothing's going on over there. We're just pulling up to Logan's house here. As you can see, it's a smaller house. Definitely no one's gonna really wanna try and burglarize it, but we still wanna make sure he's safe inside.
It's Officer Papa Jake. Is anyone home? Hello?
Jake, obviously I'm home.
Sir, what's your name?
Jake, come on.
Sir, I just wanna make sure, who are you? Sir, I need a name.
Jake, no, my name is Logan.
Okay, all right.
So it looks like the guy in here is definitely Logan. Just wanna make sure it is him, confirm it.
Is everything okay here?
Yes, Jake, I was literally getting ready for bed.
All right, you locked up at night? All right, just, you know, I'm the sheriff around here now, so I just wanna make sure you're okay. Well, you stay safe tonight. I'll be out here patrolling the streets, and have a good night.
That's why I love my job, guys. Making sure everyone's safe. We don't know who could have been in that box fort, but now that I know it's Logan, I feel a lot better. I just got back home after a great night patrol. Everything is all safe and sound for tonight. So I think it's time to hang up my cuffs for the day and finally get some shut eye. Today has been a pretty sweet day. I mean, we got to build street lights. We got to get jobs and actually make some money. So tomorrow we can go to the general store and buy some stuff. I mean, there's a ton of cool stuff in there I want to get. I want to get the air conditioning. Guys, if you have any ideas on what we should build next, like fire station, hospital, let us know down below in the comments. But I think it is late. I am tired. This is gonna be night two. Of course, as always, guys, if you want us to continue on and stay another night, be sure to smack that like button so we can crush 50,000 likes. And I think I'll be seeing you guys in the morning. Night, guys.
Good morning, everyone. It's a brand new day in the box fort.
We are awake, officially up, I think. I can't really see. And today, we finally get to get our money so we can go buy some really cool new stuff for the city.
If I was the weatherman, I'd say it's sunny. Guaranteed sunny.
I think we just jump right into it today, guys. I say we go over to Logan's house, pay him a little visit, make sure he's doing okay. My police stuff and another beautiful day in the box fort city. I don't know if Logan's up yet, so let's go knock on his door and wake him up.
Logan! Logan? Buddy, you playing music? What's going on in here? Oh, Logan is up and he is editing.
I guess I slept in a little bit.
All right, Logan's jamming out. I like it.
Breakfast. Jake, check this out.
What's...
Look at these rocks I found, Jake. A real trained archaeologist, Jake.
Looks like Logan was successful at his job and I was equally successful because no crime has happened in the city whatsoever. Oh no, Logan. Hey you, stop right there. Oh, he's got a weapon. No. Stop, it's Officer Papa Jake. Stop right now. I hit him. You're under arrest.
You're under arrest? Robbing Box Fort City General Store?
You're going away for a long time, sir. I don't know what you thought you were doing robbing our general store, but not on Officer Papa Jake's watch.
Let's go.
It's all right, Logan, I got him. General Store, Logan.
Logan didn't even care. He didn't even care the general store was getting robbed.
Come on, get up. I got a brand new prison for you. Get on in there. You're going away. Got the state-of-the-art Box Fort jail cell. All right, enjoy your stay. Our first criminal in Box Fort City.
Well, I guess it's time to meet back up with Logan and head over to the job hut. I think it's time to get paid.
Yo, Logan. Hey. Oh, dude, you missed the whole thing. I just stopped a massive robbery.
What do you mean?
The general store was robbed. I stopped the whole thing. Officer Papa Jake to the rescue.
I'm gonna go to the job hut now and get my money.
Well, same here, man. I just stopped a robbery, so I deserve my $100. Why don't we head on over together, get our money, and then we can go to the general store and buy some new stuff for our Box Fort City.
Oh, here we go. My first paycheck in Box Fort City.
$100.
All right, let's see what I get. Okay.
I mean, dude, you got some rocks. Don't be sad, man, if you don't get
Goodbye, precious rocks.
Just don't be sad. It might be $20, but that's fine. We'll get you a new job. You need as many jobs in here. All right, what'd you get, Logan?
Got $200.
Wait, what? Why did you get $200? Why did you get two? I stopped a robber. You found rocks.
I mean, maybe those rocks are valuable.
Well, I can find here. I found rocks. Do I get more money?
I don't know if those are valuable rocks, but all I know is I got some cash money.
Well, now that we have our money, we can officially head on over to the general store and grab some new stuff for our Box Fort City. But guys, the fun does not end here. We still have a ton of stuff to do. I mean, we need to build a restaurant. We need to build maybe a fire station, a movie theater, an arcade. There is a ton of stuff to do. I mean, what do all cities have? They got cruise ships. And what's the best cruise ship ever invented, Logan?
The Disney cruise ship?
No, even better, Logan, the Titanic. What if in the next episode we build the Titanic and set it to sail,
Jake,
inside the ocean?
That Titanic is dangerous.
Well, no, ours is gonna be legit and it's gonna be massive.
Logan, what happened?
Let me give you a little recap of what just happened. Everything was going my way. The sun was shining. It was a beautiful day.
It's a beautiful day, yeah.
And I decided, okay, I'm gonna jump on the unicorn.
This seems like a great idea.
This is what happened,
what
Jake.
What could go wrong? Oh, that's how they, okay.
Yeah, that makes sense how things
things went wrong for Logan. All right, well, while Logan's drying off, why don't I give you guys a little update on what is going on in Boxford City, because today is a very special day. We are gonna be building the world's biggest, the world's strongest, the world's longest box fort Titanic. It will be, quite honestly, the biggest box fort that has ever set sail in the history of mankind. Great people like Leonardo da Vinci have tried. Emperors like Julius Caesar have tried, but none of them were able to do it. And that's why today, for our box fort city, we thought it would be super sweet to build our very own Titanic.
I think we have built a Titanic before and it ended poorly.
This one's bigger, Logan. It's longer, it's badder, it's better in every single way. I'm out of adjectives, but if I had some more, I would say some other things about it because it's gonna be awesome. We've got stacks on stacks of floaties. We've got 1, 2, 3, which is gonna be the base for our Titanic. And more importantly, not rope, Logan. That's actually one of the least important things. More importantly, we've got this, the engine.
Not the little kid, he's not the engine.
This is the engine.
A Yamaha.
But Logan, if we're gonna be building the world's largest Titanic for our Boxford City and setting sail across the ocean, we're gonna need to get these floaties inflated and ready to go.
Jake, I just realized, where are we gonna build this thing?
Well, the city's kind of taking up a lot of space. I mean, we got the general store, we got Logan's house, we got streetlights, there's not really any space left. But I think if we build it right here, it'll be just enough room to build this beast, and then we can just slide her into the pool. But first things first, we need to turn these into floaties. In 3, 2, 1. Fire in the hole! And there we go! We got 2. Dude, this thing is gonna be massive. So now to make it truly the Titanic, we need the last one to go here. 3, 2, 1. Boom!
Jake, I think it's upside down.
It is upside down. That's easy to fix. That is exceptionally long.
Again, why are we doing this?
Well, because Logan, in Boxford City, it's all about making money so we can buy cool stuff to upgrade our house. And what better way to make money than owning our own cruise ship? It's a little bit of an investment right now, but once we have this bad boy up and running, guys, we are gonna have so much money. I mean, yeah, in the last episode, I tracked down that guy who stole from the general store and put him in prison. I'm a pretty good cop, but I can only be a cop for so long. Point is, Logan, we need to make big money. And to make big money, you need big investments. That's why I need all the money you have left. Cough it up. I gotta go buy some supplies from the general store.
Okay, Jake.
All right, perfect. This should be enough. All right, I'm gonna head to the general store and grab some supplies. I'll be right back.
In case you were wondering why my fort is a big green tarp, the weather forecast said it was supposed to rain a lot today. So I thought I would tarp it up just in case. I mean, I gotta say, it didn't end up raining today. If it does end up raining, we will be secure.
All right, Logan, I got it. Check it out. It's a Lamborghini.
You bought this with my money?
Listen to this baby purr.
How is this Lamborghini gonna help us with our Titanic cruise ship?
Right, that's what I went in there for. I mean, I went in there totally ready to buy Titanic cruise ship items, and then I saw this on the shelf and I thought, we deserve a little treat. Look at it. Woo!
It's like the real thing.
Jake, go put away your Lamborghini and go get us some supplies.
All right, fine. All right, guys, Logan doesn't like the Lamborghini. I don't understand why he doesn't like it. But once we get this Titanic up and running, we'll be able to buy all the Lamborghinis we want. I think I'm gonna put this Lamborghini right beside my bed. Close my bedroom door there. Only problem is now I gotta go spend all of my money on buying us supplies for the Titanic, which means if this thing fails, we're completely out of money and a pretty much failed Boxford City. If this thing works, we're gonna have enough money to build 4-story, 5-story, maybe even 6-story forts. All right, and there we go. Everything we need, from luxury items to safety vests, to escape hatches, to even a motor to power the ship. Now all we need to do is lay down our cardboard, tape this all together, and soon enough we'll be setting sail in the biggest box fort to ever sail. Alright guys, check this out. This thing is already looking massive. We actually couldn't build the entire Titanic all in one place because it's just so long.
This is only 2 floaties.
Yeah, so we need to push this into the water, deck this entire thing out, and then build another floaty, which is gonna be the captain's quarters, and we're gonna add that to the front of this. Obviously, we got a ton of really cool stuff we gotta put in here. We gotta put in like our life vest. We need tables to eat dinner. We need an engine to power the thing. There's a lot of interior work that needs to be done, but
but the shell of it is coming together and it's looking more and more like the biggest box fort to ever set sail.
Jake, I think this is big enough.
Oh, it's not big enough, Logan. We're going bigger. We're going Titanic on this thing. So we need to get the roof on this, get this in the water, build the captain's quarters, deck it out, and then we can set sail in the biggest box fort to ever sail.
We've invested a lot of resources and time into building this box fort Titanic.
We are now about ready to put the first section of the Titanic in the pool. We got one of the safety features already put on here. We've got an extra dinghy in case something were to happen. You know, safety is our number one priority. That's why we're gonna have our own emergency room in case anything bad were to happen. Now, in order to make the front of the ship, the captain's quarters, and deck the ship out, it has to be in the water. So first things first, let's get this in the pool. This isn't the full ship. This is only 2/3 of it. All right, she's looking pretty good so far.
The box fort Titanic.
Whoa. Honestly, if we went sideways with this thing fully built, you might be able to go from one side of the pool to the other without even getting wet.
Now we are connecting part one of the Titanic with the captain's quarters.
All the way to part two. So basically we need to make two doors, kind of like an airlock in a spaceship, so that once we get in the captain's quarters, we can tape the rest of the Titanic to it and have one massive boat.
Guys, Box Fort City is looking beautiful. We got Jake's house, my house over there.
Jake, have you checked on your prisoner?
I haven't, but I know that he's safe and sound inside the world's best police station, so I don't even need to worry about him. Okay, guys, now all we need to do is connect both of them like so. Check this out. This is the biggest box fort to ever set sail. Dude, if we stood this up on the side, it would be the tallest box fort ever built as well.
We need to add smokestacks. We need to employ safety devices.
We also got to make sure that the interior is true to the Titanic nature. I mean, we need to make it really fancy inside, you know, a place to have your dinner, all the stuff you'd want to have in the Titanic. Because if we're going to have customers riding this cruise ship, it needs to be as good as possible. As you can see, the ship is almost as long as the pool. Essentially, if you were to pay for your ticket and are a verified customer, the Titanic would be docked. You could simply get on and, dude, just take a look at this. I don't even know if you can see the other end. Guys, look at how long this thing is.
It's really long.
Yeah, it's still a little messy inside. We still gotta make the interior really awesome, get lights in here and all that cool stuff. But right now, this is just looking insane.
We're in the skeleton of the Titanic. Right now, it is not decorated.
To be honest, guys, right now, it doesn't look that fancy. We still have a lot of work to do in here.
But as you guys can see, the captain's quarters is down there.
To be honest, guys, right now kind of looks like a shipwreck. So we have a lot of work to do on this thing to make it tip top so that we can actually have some customers come and enjoy this thing.
Well, it is now nighttime and unfortunately, we're not gonna be able to set sail in the box for Titanic today. That's why I came back to my house and got all nice and cozy inside. When we wake up tomorrow, the first thing on the list to do is to finish the box for Titanic and set sail. I'm gonna be sleeping another beautiful night inside the box fort city. Honestly, one of my favorite box forts. I love the fact that I have an entire house to myself. I have my own little room here with my own light that I can dim and turn off when I'm going to bed. So I think I'm gonna get cozy up here in bed and get to sleep because tomorrow we got a really big day. So I'll update you guys in the morning when I wake up. Night, guys. Guys, update for you. We just woke up and there is a torrential rainstorm going on outside right now. It is like a massive. My fort is taking a massive beating. We have leaks all over. Logan's fort's taking a beating. The wind is super strong. The trees are moving. I think we need to set sail right now. If we're gonna set sail, it's right now. This isn't good, guys. Port structure is not holding. Things are leaking. Water is getting everywhere. Logan! Logan!
What's going on?
There's a massive rainstorm, bro! Look, if we're gonna set sail, Logan, it's right now.
What?
We need to set sail right
what
now.
What do you mean we're gonna set
There's
sail?
There's no other time to set sail. If the ship's gonna sink, we gotta go, we gotta go.
Jake, it is pouring rain.
We just gotta go, man.
Jake, there's water coming in through the fort.
I see that, Logan. It's dripping everywhere. There's a torrential rainstorm. It's like a hurricane.
And you wanna go in the Titanic?
Yeah, I think it's the only way. We gotta set sail.
Jake, it's not a good idea to set sail in a thunderstorm.
We have to, Logan. It's the only way. Wait. Grab some of the safety.
Jake, I think I just saw lightning.
Okay. She's already taking on water, bro.
Jake, this is not gonna work.
We gotta set sail, Logan! It's the only way!
Let's just have to stop inside. Where's your life jacket?
I don't have a life jacket, Jake!
No,
Jake, we're taking in a lot of water right now.
Water, Logan, she was built to be a luxury cruise ship. Thunder's picking up. The wind is really strong.
Jake, I think we need to get out.
There's no getting out of the ship, Logan. Listen to me.
We built this Titanic to last, and that's exactly what it's going to do.
It's going to last. We keep sailing.
Yes. You go to the You make yourself a nice breakfast.
What, Jake? Now is no time for breakfast!
We're sailing the ship!
Alright, Captain's Log 4792. The ship is holding up. The rain is very strong. There's also thunder. Do not try this at home. There is thunder and lightning. Looks like the wind is picking up though, and the waves are getting extremely strong. The ship's getting thrown around like crazy.
This is not what we wanted to do. We wanted to make this a luxury box fort. We wanted to have a nice dining room, a place to sleep, a place to eat. This was supposed to be a billionaire cruise ship. We did not anticipate waking up and having it be a torrential downpour. We have water leaking on the ship in all places, and my main concern right now is keeping this thing afloat. It was not built for a hurricane.
Logan!
Oh no!
Well, there you go, buddy.
Jake?
Yeah?
What's wrong? My knee's going through the floor.
Oh, no, Logan! Oh, no.
Jake! Logan! Jake, my knee! Okay. This is okay, we have a structural breach. It's called a structural breach. You're gonna be, why are you drinking your coffee right now? This is an emergency. Oh wait, you got breakfast. See, I told you guys, the ship comes with breakfast. That's the beautiful thing about the Titanic. It's got the nicest breakfast. Honestly, if you ever do ride it right, we're in an emergency. Logan, just stay calm, okay? I'm gonna go to the captain's quarters to figure this thing out.
Stress eating, Jake.
All right, don't stress eat. Mess.
Oh no, captain's quarters is taking a massive beating, Logan.
Oh no, Logan, we're taking on water.
Logan, the captain's
quarters is taking. Oh, no. We got an emergency right now, Logan. The captain's quarters is going down.
Logan!
Dang.
Logan,
you gotta grab him, man. The captain's quarters is going down. We're losing her. Oh, no. We're losing the Titanic, guys. The Titanic is officially starting to sink.
Jake, you spent all our money on this place.
I didn't think there was gonna be a hurricane. And why are you still eating?
All right, well, at least we have the main section of the ship, okay? We just gotta reinforce her, make sure she doesn't sink. We're already out at sea, we can't afford it to go down. Oh, no. All right, batten down the hatches, Logan. We're in for a rough ride here, buddy.
Not my coffee!
Oh, no.
Not my coffee!
Jake, what's that noise?
I think we sprung a leak!
Oh, no.
The ship's going down, Logan.
Oh, hold in there! She's going down! We need to get the walls back up. We can fix her.
Jake, where's our safety equipment?
I'm the only one that has it.
Jake!
We're sinking at an alarming rate.
Jake?
All right, just stay calm. Stay calm.
It's taking on water.
We're taking on a lot of water. All right, just stay calm.
Why do you spill your coffee?
Jake, this isn't good.
Here.
All right, this part of the ship's still up.
Right.
All right, if we can make it to the...
What's happening? What's that coming after me?
Be very safe, Jake.
I don't feel safe at all.
Jake, this part of the ship is fully submerged in water.
Okay.
All right, listen. I have an idea, okay? If we can get to the second part of the ship, we should be okay. Here. We're gonna take the safety equipment off. We're gonna bring the Yamaha.
Jake, what's the Yamaha gonna do?
It's gonna help us get out of this mess.
We gotta climb up this wall. Looks like the main part of the ship is holding up pretty well.
I think the front and the back took a big beating, and that's why we're losing it.
Oh, Jake.
Jake, we didn't even get to decorate this place.
We didn't, and the rain's still coming down. But if you think about it, we do have a roof over our heads.
You had breakfast. I mean, if this isn't luxury, I don't know what it is.
Jake, do not try and spin this.
We have a little bit of time left before this section of the fort starts sinking.
All right, guys, I've got an idea. I've got a wrench here.
Jake, where did you get a wrench?
Well, it's part of the safety features on the ship.
If I can get underneath the ship with the Yamaha, I might be able to repair it and stop it from leaking. I can save the main section of the ship. It's a bit risky, but I'm gonna have to go underwater.
I don't know if you've looked around, but I don't think this ship is worth salvaging.
We're gonna have to try, Logan. It's our only shot. All right, going under.
Thank you.
Now all we need to do is find out where the leak's coming from and try and patch it.
Can't be too hard.
I found a little air pocket underneath the ship.
Jake, I don't think there's any chance of fixing this boat.
We gotta try, Logan, come on.
I think I might have found out what's wrong. I think I might be able to fix it. And if I just turn this right, we should be, oh no. Get back on the ship now.
I think the Titanic is going down completely this time. I thought I could fix her. I thought we could build the world's biggest box for never set sail. Who would have thought that it would have sunk? Oh no. There's gotta be something we can do here. Here, let's get to the cafeteria, come on.
Ship's already gone.
No.
The storm stopped at least.
Well, that's great, Logan.
That's good to know. There's a porthole here.
The whole box for Titanic has gone down.
Well, at least we're still in this part of the ship. I mean, it's pretty okay right now, other than the massive amount of water. I mean, it's like...
I don't even have my coffee.
That's true, but we can make it over here in the kitchen. And just come on over to the kitchen.
It's in that part of the ship that's also sunk, but...
Well, Jake, it's a good thing I tarped my fort. It's all still intact.
Unfortunately, I think our business venture to make a bunch of money in the Titanic didn't work out. So it looks like in the next video, we're gonna need new jobs and new ways to get money.
Not me, Jake, I'm an archaeologist.
Sure. We'll figure that out.
But guys, we have a lot of building to do and a lot of patching up on this fort. So do not forget to smack that like button. Let's try and crush 50,000 likes. And we'll see you guys next time for another awesome video. We'll be right back.